Welcome to a lesson on the repeated nearest neighbor algorithm. Using the graph here on the left, in a previous lesson, we found the lowest cost Hamiltonian circuit using the brute force algorithm to be the circuit ABCEDA that had a total weight of 19. We knew this was the lowest cost Hamiltonian circuit, or optimal Hamiltonian circuit, because remember the brute force method is the only method that guarantees to find the lowest cost Hamiltonian circuit. Then we found the Hamiltonian circuit using the nearest neighbor algorithm to be AEDCBA, which had a total weight of 21, not the lowest cost Hamiltonian circuit. But we can improve on the nearest neighbor algorithm by applying the algorithm from each vertex. And this is the repeated nearest neighbor algorithm. So step one, we perform the nearest neighbor algorithm starting in each vertex, and then two, we choose the circuit produced with a minimal total weight. And just a review, to apply the nearest neighbor algorithm, step one, we start at a vertex. Step two, we move to the nearest unvisited vertex using the edge with the smallest weight. And then three, we repeat until the circuit is complete. So let's go ahead and apply the repeated nearest neighbor algorithm to the same graph. So we'll begin at vertex A, and notice how we can visit vertex B, E, or D, but E is the closest because edge AE has a weight of 2. So we'll go from A to E, and now from here, it does appear like we have 3 choices, but we really only have 2, because if we went to C, we could not visit D and B and then return to A without using a vertex more than once. So we can visit either B or D. Notice edge ED has a weight of 1, so we'll visit D next. And now we only have one choice. We have to visit C, B, and then A. So we have the circuit AED, and then CBA. So the total weight would be 2 plus 1 plus 6 plus 7 plus 5. Which is equal to a total weight of 21. Now we'll start at vertex B. The closest vertex to vertex B is going to be vertex E, because edge BE has a weight of 3. Again, here we only have 2 choices. We can visit either A or C, but notice how the 2 edges have the same weight, so we're actually going to have 2 circuits starting at vertex B. Let's first visit A, so we'll go from E to A. From here we have one choice. We have to visit vertex D, then C, and then B. So this gives us the circuit BEA, DCB, which would have a total weight of 3 plus 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 7, which is equal to 22. And again, we'll have another circuit starting with B and then E. Remember, here we went from E to A, now we'll go from E to C. So from B we visit E, and then because these 2 edges have the same weight and we just went to A, we'll now go to C. And now we have one choice, we'll go from C to D, from D to A, and A back to B. So the circuit is BEC, DAB. So the weight would be 3 plus 2 plus 6 plus 4 plus 5, giving us a total weight of 20. And now we'll move to vertex C. Starting at vertex C, the nearest vertex would be vertex E, since edge CE has a weight of 2. From here, the nearest vertex is vertex D with a weight of 1. From here, we have one choice. We have to visit A, then B, then back to C. So our circuit is CED, ABC, which has a weight of 2 plus 1, plus 4, plus 5, plus 7, which is equal to 19. And now we'll move to vertex D. So starting at vertex D, the nearest vertex is vertex E. Edge DE has a weight of 1. And again, from here, we only have two choices. We can visit A or C. And notice how these two edges have the same weight. So again, we'll have two circuits starting at vertex D. Let's first visit vertex A. Now we only have one choice. We have to visit vertex B, then C, and then D. So this gives us the circuit DEA, BCD. So we'd have a total weight of 1 plus 2 plus 5 plus 7 plus 6, which is equal to 21. And now instead of going from E to A, we'll now go from E to C. So again, because these two edges have the same weight and we just visited A, we'll now visit C. And now we only have one choice. We have to visit B, then A, and then D. So the circuit would be DEC, BAD. So the total weight would be 1 plus 2 plus 7 plus 5 plus 4, which is 19. And then finally, we need to start at vertex E. So starting at vertex E, the nearest vertex is vertex D. Edge ED is a weight of 1. From here, we can visit either vertex A or C. But since edge DA is a weight of 4, we'll visit vertex A. From here, we have to go to vertex B, then C, then back to E. So we have the circuit EDA, BCE, with a total weight of 1 plus 4 plus 5 plus 7 plus 2, which is also 19. And now we select the circuit with the least weight, but notice how there are three circuits here that have a total weight of 19. So let's take a closer look at these three circuits. In our previous examples, we always started at vertex A, so let's rewrite these circuits starting at vertex A to the circuits found using the different methods. So looking at this circuit here, if we start at vertex A, notice how we'd go from A to B to C. And then from C, notice how we would visit vertex E, D, and then return to A. Now let's take a look at this circuit here. Starting at A, we'd go from vertex A to vertex D. And then from D, we'd visit vertex E, C, B, and then back to A. And these circuits are actually duplicates. They're just given in the reverse order. Notice A, B, C, E, D, A, in reverse order would be the same circuit as A, D, E, C, B, A. Now let's take a look at this last circuit. Again, starting at vertex A, we'd have the circuit ABC, which we have here, E, and then D, and then A, which is the same as this circuit here. So if we compare this circuit to our previous results, you see here at the bottom, notice how this is the same circuit that we found using brute force, which we know is the optimal or lowest cost Hamiltonian circuit. So by using the repeated nearest neighbor algorithm, we do have a better chance of determining the lowest cost or optimal Hamiltonian circuit. I think we'll have to stop here for this lesson. I hope you found this helpful.